Are you here to find out whether metformin can lead to vitamin B12 deficiency? Well, it does. At the end of the video, I'll show you 4 tips on how to prevent B12 deficiency if you're on metformin. Coming up. Firstly, let's find out how metformin works and what it does. Insulin is a hormone produced by your pancreas, and it moves the sugar from your blood, like after a meal, into cells, where they can be used as energy. You can think of insulin as a key helping glucose into various cells. Now, what happens in diabetes is your blood fat cells, liver cells, and muscle cells do not respond well to insulin. This is called insulin resistance. Your pancreas ends up producing more insulin to try to push sugar into your cells, but it reaches a point when it can't keep up and there's too much sugar in your bloodstream. Metformin reduces insulin resistance, thus helping sugar move into the cells. That's why you want to take metformin with your meals. This also reduces side effects from metformin. Metformin also reduces the amount of sugar produced by the liver. Did you know that the liver produces sugar? The problem is, if you're a diabetic, the liver ends up producing more sugar than you need because of insulin resistance. If you take metformin, the production of glucose is reduced in your liver, resulting in lower sugar levels in your blood. The third way metformin helps is it decreases intestinal absorption of glucose. If you eat a meal, food passes through your digestive system to your intestines. Therefore, after a meal, your blood sugar level rises. Metformin delays the absorption of glucose during digestion. And if you're finding value in this video, don't forget to like, comment, and share. And click on that notification bell and hit the subscribe button as well. For the most part, metformin is fairly well tolerated. However, it does have some side effects, especially when you're starting off with the drug. And if you want to learn more about the side effects of metformin and how to avoid them, click on this link above. Now, what can happen if you have been on metformin for many months or years? Metformin can cause vitamin B12 deficiency. Low levels of vitamin B12 have been seen as early as 3 to 4 months after starting metformin, and in other cases, they have been seen after 5 to 10 years of treatment. In a cross-sectional study looking at this, up to 1/3 of patients on metformin were B12 deficient. What are the symptoms of B12 deficiency? If you do have B12 deficiency, it can affect your blood count, and in more severe cases, it can affect your brain as well as your nerve cells. A low blood count can affect different blood cells. If your red blood count is affected, you become anemic. Your doctor might say your hemoglobin is low. This can also cause different symptoms such as fatigue, shortness of breath, or feeling lightheaded. If your white cell count is affected and decreased, you're at an increased risk of an infection. Lastly, if your platelets are affected, you are at an increased risk for bleeding and bruising. What are the symptoms if your brain and nerve cells are affected? If you become B12 deficient, the protective covering called myelin around your nerve fibers are damaged, resulting in different symptoms such as numbness and tingling of your feet or hands. This is called neuropathy. You might even have trouble walking, your mood can be affected, presenting as irritability or depression. Memory can be affected, presenting with forgetfulness, slowing of your cognition, and in some cases, even as dementia. That is why B12 levels are always checked if you're being worked up for dementia. If you're interested to see if there's a link between metformin and dementia, click on the link above. Here are 4 tips to prevent B12 deficiency. Tip number 1, make sure you're getting it from your diet. Some good resources are in animal products, including fish, meat, poultry, eggs, milk, and milk products. Vitamin B12 is generally not present in plant foods, but a good resource are fortified breakfast cereals. Tip number 2, calcium supplementations seems to reduce this effect of metformin. The study which you're seeing right here in diabetes care showed that increased intake of calcium reversed vitamin B12 malabsorption of metformin. The dose they used was 1.2 grams of calcium given daily. Tip number three, if B12 deficiency is severe, and I'm talking about severe nerve damage caused by metformin, then discontinue metformin and talk to your doctor about an alternative way of managing your diabetes. Progression of nerve damage can be stopped with an adequate B12 supplementation. However, the nerve damage for the most part cannot be reversed. Neurological and psychiatric symptoms can improve over several months. Tip number four, in milder to moderate cases, B12 can be replaced with 1,000 to 2,000 micrograms of cyanocobalamin. This is given daily and your doctor can follow up by checking your blood level for B12. In severe cases, your doctor might opt to replace the vitamin B12 in the form of an injection. Some doctors might start off with the injectable form of vitamin B12 and later on switch to oral supplementation. Here's a link to a video discussing when you should not take metformin. Question of the day. If you're on metformin, did your doctor check your B12 level? And if you're interested in a video looking at B12 deficiency in more detail, type yes in the comments below. And if you're interested in more videos, click right here, or click right here, click right here, or click right here. Think your health and have a good day. Not good, try again, it's cold. Think your health, think your health, think your health, think. My hand is also hurting. Why is my hand hurting? It's so cold. Think your health and have a good day.